Hello guys, here we are for game two of the female C League. I was abandoned by my co-caster, so I will be trying to
10
cast this
seconds
alone.
remaining.
So bear with me, please. Also, it's
5
early
seconds
here in
remaining.
Portugal, so I'll try to do my best. It's
Reserve
Kraken Ladies
time.
versus Mum I Need Tangoes, which is what we hear every single game at the beginning.
Radiant
We
team's
start
turret
with a
ban.
draw ban. Makes sense. Yesterday we saw some games where a draw was very useful with her aura for the team, even though she was recently nerfed. Void
Fire
ban
team down.
for Mum I Need Tangoes. Don't want to deal with that initiation and that lockdown. See what happens here. Some friends of mine requested that I would put some
10 seconds
overlays over this,
remaining.
so I'm trying that for the first time. So,
Five seconds
mistakes might be
remaining.
made, but hopefully everything smoothly.
Reserve time.
Curious to see what direction they go today. Yesterday we saw some games where there was a lot of five manning.
Radiant
There
team
was
down.
a strategy of destruction for a meepo to farm. So let's see. No cheesy strategy with the next ban for Kraken Ladies being Shadow Demon.
10 seconds remaining.
And there goes Ogre
Dire team's
Magi.
turret.
This is exactly what we would expect after a TI for bans here in the sea, though.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Disruptor.
And we see a
Radiant team's
peculiar
turret
first
has.
pick for Kraken Ladies. There's a Disruptor. Not usually the first support to be picked, is a bit weak in the laning stage, I would say, but offers a great team fight. See where
Ten
they go with
seconds
this.
remaining.
It's also a good lockdown for heroes like Sark.
5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
As you can imagine, I will not try to talk during this entire stage because, well, you'll get sick of my voice and I don't have that much to say while there's no picks. So let's see. They are using all of their time. They seem to be thinking a lot about this. Yesterday, the picks were way quicker.
Keeper of the Light.
Okay, we see
Radiant
another
team's turret
support being
has.
picked for Mint. Keeper of the Light. Great push. Great team fight also. The possibility of recalling for later rats. We'll see also what's gonna happen here.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
I would like to see some Naga coming out for this
Reserve
Keeper of the
time.
Light, for instance. That would be interesting. And we see a Tidehunter for Mint. Offlaning, perhaps. And another Great Teamfighter lockdown. So are they going for the strategy of the greatest teamfight here? We'll see.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Lion.
Oh, now a lion for Kraken Ladies. Okay then, so we have both supports coming out here. Flexible, they can gank a bit together also. They can just do a more passive laning stage.
Dire team's turn to
Ancient Apparition Band for Mint. So maybe going for someone that needs that regen. Something like a Huskar, like we saw yesterday. Maybe Alk.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Queen of Pain is gone. Also.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. 10 seconds remaining. Dire team ban.
Another interesting ban coming out. Noble Seeker for Kraken Ladies.
Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
And no Sven.
Ten seconds remaining.
Oh, there comes the Undying. That might explain that AA ban. Very good sustain, cures for his team.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Team fight going very strong for Mint right now. If they 5-man and they work around their cooldowns, there's very little that Kraken can do. But at the same time, they have heroes that fall off in the late game a lot. Like Undying if he doesn't get a good start, so... Kraken needs to get active. Oh, a Slaughter coming out for Kraken Ladies. That offers some kind of flexibility. We don't know if it can be the core Slaughter on the safe lane. It can be the offlaner. Maybe going out for something less armor strategy, since they banned out the Sven, which is usually the counter for the less armor strats.
5 seconds remaining.
Meanwhile, I'm sorry, but I'm also trying to solve some technical issues here. The team.
Dire team's turn to pick.
Okay, a Raid King. Another hero that needs lifesteal. Coming out for Mint. This should be their core. And another strong team fighter. And a Viper for Kraken Ladies. So this Red King is gonna have a hard time not being kited around. Curious to see if this Viper probably will be mid with a starter offlane, so we're missing the safe lane core. And for Mint, we should be missing the mid.
5 seconds remaining.
I'm gonna try to quickly solve the technical issues here for a sec. Sorry guys, we're back. Last pick a Juggernaut for Kraken Ladies. So this hero can become active very early. Also playing around his ultimate, he can gank very well. He's a relatively autonomous hero, so he can stay alone in the safe lane while the Lion and the Disruptor go gank. And well, with less armor from Slaughter, he should have a field time. Maybe this, they can also just put him around. Oh, and we have a surprise! There's a Pugna coming out now for Mint. Going more even for the push, I would say, but with a strange lineup. We'll see who goes mid in this case. Okay guys, here we are. I'm sorry for any problems that might have occurred. I was trying to solve some delays here. Okay, so we have... Let's see what's the laning state should be. Yes, we should have this Pugna for Mint going mid. Possibly against the Viper, curious matchup. Let's see who comes up on top. I will remind you that Viper is kind of one of the hardest mids to go against, since he has corrosive skin to defend himself and they can harass forever. We will have the Juggernaut on the safe lane and probably Arlequin with her Slaughter on the off lane. Then the two supports, and I'm curious to see where Mint will put her own heroes here. What is this Undying doing exactly? He should be co-supporting with the Keeper of the Light. Tidehunter is offlane. No Hand of the Jungle on him though.
The battle's starting.
I'll take that.
Hopefully the next stream will go way smoother, because we had some issues the last minute here. The game starting. But here we go. On their own. And let's see how the start goes here for this Pugna and this Viper on the mid lane. Viper is relatively protected with this entries. Pugna is gonna have a good time, at least in the beginning. and stay back. Tidehunter went for a poor man's shield. Interesting choice. Since he has Kraken Shell, I'm not so sure about this, but we'll see if he can stay in the lane without being zoned out. Very hard lane. If the Lion gets out a good X and the Jugger Blade Furies him, he might have a bad time, but for now, Lion's going very low on health. And what about here? This Slaughter is being harassed out of the lane. Wraith King, Keeper of the Light with Chakra Magic first, so he will assure those stuns, I guess.
Nay, I say.
Very passive start here for starters. Have the Disruptor doing the babysitting job. How's we on vision? We have this word for mint in the mid lane and nothing else much coming out. Oh, we have a sentry here blocking this camp.
Illusion.
Top lane, this Tidehunter is level 3 already. So he's not being zoned out indeed at all by this lane. They are tri-laning now, probably trying to get something out of this. And the biggest winner of this laning stage appears to be this Pugna, who is sitting at the top network, doing just fine. I imagine this is his bottle coming out, yeah. On the top lane, they are going on the Tidehunter, and it's first blood.
Last of my kind, but first.
Finally, Kraken does it when they make the Disruptor go there also. This will help them, will help a lot in the early game. And he is the top of the network now. Meanwhile, this Wraith King is also farming though, peacefully. Keeper of the Light went for the point in mana leak now. So we will probably try to go aggressive. See if that works though, because this Slaughter is very careful. Sitting at 3 levels, also not being zoned out at all. Now they've rotated mid, trying to gank the Pugna. Success there though. Pugna sees them coming. Very curious on what the build for this Pugna will be. Viper went for a poison attack and nether toxin. No points in corrosive skin so far. He's getting a bit behind the Pugna though. Supports for Kraken as expected, going a bit more around the map, which leaves it free for Tidehunter top though. Sitting now at level 4. And this Jugger, something is not going right because this Jugger is very behind. Hopefully if he can get a kill with this, he will get back in the game. Yes. There goes another level for him. He was being a bit starved because his supports were sitting with him. But another kill for Kraken and for Juggernaut. Will definitely. So. Larder is also fine, finally got his Iron Talon now. With this he can just go to the jungle if needed. He's almost got a kill on the Keeper of the Light there. The stun coming out though from the Wraith King. Devil. And he's dead. There goes the Slaughter. This Wraith King shouldn't be underestimated when he has Chakra Magic to go with him, basically. The stun's coming out, now he has 1 point in his criticals and some vampire aura. He's fine. Right now the top shards, we have that precisely. Keeper of the Light very low, must be careful. Jugger keeps farming away, Pugna right after him. And this Viper is falling off incredibly to this Pugna. Sitting now level 6 with a good advantage. No one top. Tower being pushed, interesting.
Middle is missing.
The tide will keep being here. Trigger is having a good time, so no points in the healing so far. They want, they can keep going on this Tidehunter. They have the glimpse and the kinetic field set up, so... He is tanky though. And he has Ravage now, so that will not help. Verify use by Disruptor trying to survive this Tidehunter. He's left out of no mana for Ravage, so he will back off. Meanwhile, bottom, we still have Slaughter battling off these three heroes. Now sitting at level 4. Decent for 6 minutes in. An offlaner. The Tomb was also committed for this. This Undying sitting at level 3. And this Keeper of the Light at level 4. Pretty standard stuff. Yesterday we saw some supports being very starved, but this seems pretty okay right now. Yeah. Disruptor and Dying being the least in here. Slaughter also falling off compared a bit. And Tide is going on this. And he will get the kill. Disruptor goes down for this Tidehunter that is now better in the game. Well, you were all thinking the 6 agility wouldn't help, weren't you? Well, certainly helped with those right clicks. So we have level 7, Ravage ready to go. Curious to see what he's gonna go for, if it's gonna go to back or not. It would appear so since they have this pushing lineup. Pugna is still having a trip day. Going for... Oh, the Pugna maybe is going for that mech instead of the Tide. So we'll be seeing maybe a blink for the Tidehunter here. Jugger got the Pugna though when going for the rune, so yeah. This Jugger is going to be a problem because now he's sitting at 3-0-1. Farming very okay, probably going for a Battle Fury for later. Wraith King almost got Slaughter here, but is diving a bit too much. Needs to back off with the help of Undying. Keeper of the Light is also there to help him with sustain. That's mana leak, 2 points, Illuminate. Oh, curious build also. He wants everything. He's going for 2 points in Illuminate, 2 points in mana leak, and 1 point in Chakra Magic. Wraith King is going for his armlet first item, probably. Yeah, I'm trying to see the chat here, and I do agree that this is being a very passive game so far. It's not something that you necessarily see on these games, and it's not because Sia nor because it's female players. Yesterday we had very violent games. I think it's probably more due to the nature of their draft. Kraken here wants to get some key items before they become more aggressive, and they are still getting those kills with a Jugger rotation, so they are fine with that so far. Meanwhile, I'm guessing Mint wants to push, and what I find strange here is they are not grouping up yet. And we have the level 8 on this Tidehunter, this Pugna is level 8 also with this headdress and trying to get that mid tower. Everyone is pretty much sticking to their lanes, which is kind of... Well, it's weird at this point, people would expect some kind of action, some kind of rotation as 5, trying to get some pick off so they can push some tower. No one saw that missed stun, we'll go back to top. Yeah, so much, nothing much to report here. Okay, they are grouping up mid though. We'll see if they smoke or what they decide to do. There's a ward for Kraken there though, so I'm not so sure it's a good idea to do anything under this. Oh, and here they come, pushing mid. Just the three heroes that can push better. They need to be careful with Glimpse though, and there's the Glimpse for Undying. Immediately commits the Tomb. There's Pugna going ham on the Viper. Suddenly there's a Slaughter also coming out, and Wraith King also joins, and we have a pause on the game at a very inappropriate moment. I don't know exactly what's going on, but the Kraken team is having lag issues, apparently. That can't help. We'll see if this Wraith King will salvage the fight. No one died, the Viper got back. We have a tomb though, and this Slaughter is in trouble. It goes down to the Pugna as they keep sustaining themselves with the help of the Undying, and the Wraith King is already coming on that tower and going for that lion that was trying to defend, and the lion will go down. Uses finger before he goes, but it's to no avail. There's also reincarnation on the Wraith King yet, and he has a mango that he can pop if he needs for that. So here's the five men pushing that we were talking about. They join together, they get objectives, they get kills. Tidehunter still has his Ravage that he didn't have to commit, so they can just keep pushing. The Pugna also has his ulti again, and he uses his Nether Ward. So this Wraith King doesn't care if he goes down, because he can just reincarnate, which is gonna happen now to the tower hits. And maybe they overextended a bit, because we see Viper and Slaughter going off on this Tidehunter. He commits Ravage to get the Viper, and Viper goes down to the Wraith King. Another kill now for Pugna, and this Pugna is top of the chart again, working on his mech that is almost completed, and this teamfight on mid, second tower, has been going on for 10 minutes now. No one wants to commit, except that Cottle goes a bit too much further, and he goes down to the Jugger. Slaughter also makes a mistake out of position, and he goes down for the Pugna. So we have what should be something like a 4-4-2 going on now for in favor of Mint. They keep pushing a bit. Okay, they back off finally. Probably getting some key items on them. Wraith King has his armlets ready to go. The Undying has not much, but it is fine as luck as this is. And there's the mech for Pugna. So they keep just going together on the bot lane now, going for the tier 1. Their game plan seems to be working so far. They're not letting Kraken get his key items on them. This lion is very, very far from any kind of a blink dagger. Disruptor, not much to his name either. Jugger is working on his Battle Fury, trying to go late game. And the Slaughter also is very far from any kind of initiation tool. So we're gonna see them now pushing into this mid tower. No Ravage though, no reincarnation. Disruptor is caught up by Pugna on the backside. He commits his Static Storm, and yet it's to no avail because he will go down. And Slaughter is going ham on this Tidehunter. Is very, very tanky though, and is stunned, and he will go down for the Wraith King. Lion tries to survive this, but there's a tomb, there's much magic damage, there's a Wraith King hitting everyone on the face. Pugna still on the top of the charts, followed by the Wraith King. That is interesting. Viper is not even trying to go into the team fights with only his Aquila now. He's falling way, way behind the other cores. The vision coming out now for Kraken is very good, but they can't really make use of it because they cannot cross this river. They are constrained, no towers bottom, no towers mid, and if everything is gonna go as it went so far, Mint is probably gonna push tops very soon. See how we're doing here. Cottle is gonna start working on his Ags naturally. I would like very much to see a blink on that Wraith King, so that he gets more pickoffs on those supports that try to go on their backlines.
Radiant's top tower has looked better.
So far everyone backs, trying to get their farm. Jugger safely with his ulti bottom. His battle fury must be completed soon, I would imagine. This Viper possibly going for the mech himself. We will see, he has nothing so far and beat a lot of gold. And with ultis up and a blink coming for the Tidehunter, this will be problematic. Undying goes into Disrupture and is glimpsed back, commits the Tomb. There's also Tidehunter though, if they want they can go for this. There's Static Storm committed this for defense and they went for the poor Lion instead that was left back and Pugna just, you know, sucks the life out of him. This Pugna pick being extraordinary and Disruptor is in trouble, he will try to get off of this and he will not succeed. And Slardar commits his Amplify damage to go down with to make Undying go down. Jugger gets the kill. Tidehunter tries to back off, he is visible now with the Amplify damage, so Slardar will pursue him. No blink yet, coming out for the Tidehunter, but he has it on his inventory, so he should be okay. Commits Ravage though, but the Jugger was already spinning, so he doesn't care, but there's suddenly four other heroes, and the Jugger goes down for the Gossip, this Pugna. That is going to be a problem, because this Tier 2 has looked better. See some golds here amassed for this Rift King. Dire's top tower is under attack. Yeah, some mistakes in positioning coming out for Kraken for sure. They should be more careful because they have a lot of initiation right now. And they can also just run into them. It's incredible because they are so durable right now. There's nothing. This Viper, it can't do anything. It has an Ogre Club, maybe going for that Dragon Lance. But it's completely useless in this team fights. They just put the Tomb up and there they go. They go ham. They have this Wraith King sitting at 3000 gold with his armlet. This Pugna has his Greaves already. So the sustain here is incredible with the help also of this Undying and this Coddle. When this Coddle gets his axe, it will be impossible to do anything during daytime because that's healing would be come out. Also, they're just 5 manning, so there's not much potentially in gankings or pickoffs from the side of Kraken. The Jugger went for the Battle Fury very, I wouldn't say super late, but still in this game it might be too late. Slardar is still trying to get the money for his Blink Dagger. Everyone backing off a bit. And they go for the Rosh, but Disruptor is seen by Tidehunter, tries to glimpse. And he will probably go down here because 5 heroes rotate and he's dead. Dead for the Tidehunter that has his Blink already. Wraith King keeps getting the money. I wonder what he's going to do with this. They keep going for their objectives, they got the pick off, they went for the... There's not much that can be done, considering that if they try to contest this, they will lose it for sure, so... Jugger is just trying to get something in return, in the form of this tier 1 mid. Top, they're also pushing a bit, this Viper has his Dragon Lance completed, finally. This Viper is very, very low, even... lower than the Tidehunter in a farm, which you don't want your mids to be. And the Pugna keeps being on top of the chart, which is really interesting. He gets the Aegis himself, because, you know, Wraith King doesn't really need it. I'm not sure if this Wraith King is gonna go something like a Radiance or something, because of the amount of money he has on the bank right now. Very curious to see about that. Keeper of the Light also working on his Axe, he's been playing super well this game, keeping back. Yeah, his Axe must be coming very, very soon. Let's see how we are kills that. I have the idea that yes, he is 119, which is very, very good for a Keeper of the Light, playing against a Jugger with a Slardar and a Lion, all these things that could easily kill him, but he's been keeping completely to the back, just charging his horses. Undying also going for the Axe, which is going to be another form of incredible sustain and make them all squishy with this, what's the name of the thing again, with this decay, making it very, very hard for them to sustain themselves in team fights. The Jugger is not enough. They are keeping to the base Kraken now. They are conscious that if they get out of the base right now, they will probably be picked off. Not sure about this vision for mint here, but oh yeah, they have something on the mids. They have something on the sides, the secret shop. Yeah, if they see someone, they don't know. Also, for Kraken, the thing is, they see their own side shop, but they don't see anything else. So, or do they? I see. Where's your? Yeah, it's over here. So, and they also, oh, they just have a observer ward right now. It's a kind of a strange observer ward since it's gonna block this camp, which they could use to farm for themselves because it's still considerable near to their base. But well. I guess they are so afraid that they want to make sure they can get out a bit of the base. Pugna is still going around with this Necromannikan level 1. So the push coming out is gonna get even stronger, and they're preparing to assault a high ground. 6-1-6 Pugna mids against the Viper. This is very impressive stuff coming out of this Pugna. They keep pushing into every lane. The Jugger is trying to come back with his Yasha now, just trying to farm whatever is safe, now TPing back. And Mint will probably charge anytime soon with their Aegis. The Tidehunter has now a pipe. Yes, guys, the poor man's shield is gone. Rejoice. But we have a pipe for them, which is gonna make life harder for the magical damage coming out from Kraken. They have kind of a mix of magical and physical because of the Slaughter and the Jugger as well for the physical. But this will certainly help make them even more durable. They slowly siege the high ground. Wraith King is not there, it's only Pugna and the rest of his team. But he can just, walk up and use his Nether Blast, and no one can do anything about that. They are so scared. They have a ward now to see the entrance at least, so they can kind of try to defend themselves. Oh no, wait, sorry. This ward is for Mint. So yeah, they are much in problem. Okay, they saw the ward now, they warded it. No high ground vision, that would make it even worse for Kraken to try to defend. Wraith King is pushing the entire lane bot, and he went for the Sacred Relic. So yeah, I'm expecting some Radiance coming out for him, which would be interesting because this Jugger is a bit behind, so he will need to get an MKB, which he doesn't really want. And if he doesn't get one, they will probably not be able to deal with this Wraith King. The Viper is nowhere near anything that can help them. It's being pretty useless this game, actually. And here they go. They stun them, they control them, and they try to take the mid tower. Okay. A good static storm committed on all heroes, it's not enough though. Jugger goes in, Jugger tries to kill them, and he goes. The Pugna goes down, he has Aegis though, and Jugger is down, Slaughter is down, Lion is down, and this seems to be looking very bad for Kraken because they are hitting at the barracks now. A, they don't intend to stop. This Wraith King with his Radiance armlet build, old build that we haven't seen, I guess, for a bit, is not gonna stop. And this Pugna with this Guardian Greaves will help them keep them top on. So basically, here they go. Now, bottom tower, analytical. They go together, they start, and finger committed, but it's not enough because a Ravage comes out. So Lion is down, this Viper and this Disruptor have to back off. Meanwhile, Slaughter is trying to get something. Oh, he got the Wraith King. That was a very good kill. But he goes down to the Keeper of the Lights. Bottom, Tidehunter also goes down. A bit of a comeback on the defense. Kraken managed to keep this tower alive, actually, on the bottom. With this kill, especially the Wraith King kill, that I must have given quite some money to them, actually. Let's see. Wraith King, yeah. 1000 gold, that will certainly help this Jugger come back also into the game. And let's see, Pugna is still ahead though. Yeah, he needs more than this probably. But they fend them off, they get some time. Aegis is gone. There's no big items coming out anytime soon probably. But this Viper has 2000 gold now. So he might go for whatever he wants this game. I don't know exactly what that is though, to be honest. What can help them against this push? The Keeper of Light has his axe ready. This is gonna be bad. There's four staff coming out for the Tidehunter that will help. Let's see. Necro level 3 already on the Pugna. So next time they march up these lanes, it will probably be harder even for Kraken to defend. They have their ultis up already. however, so that might help. There's also finally the blink dagger for Slaughter. And there's a blink coming out for the Wraith King as well. So now the initiation is even worse. They keep avoiding each other. Kraken trying to farm as much as possible on the bottom lane, trying to avoid every place that they know that Mint is gonna be waiting for them. And the Jugger manages to avoid that stun with the well-placed Blade Fury, and he backs off. There's some vision here for both teams, that's why they are playing the game of avoidance. Oh, except that Viper is caught up in the mid lane and he goes down too. Pugna, bad positioning there, and suddenly is in the middle of all the heroes and goes down. That will not help him. He was going for his BKB, which will now played with this. And with the Viper pick off, Wraith King decides to push bottom, try to go again on the same tower that they were trying to go before. Again, a very organized style of game, very objective based, a bit like what we saw yesterday also, coming out from Power Rangers. Now we have a recall also constantly on this Keeper of the Light, so that will help them keep getting pick-offs and then push us 5. And they're knocking at the door of Kraken, bottom lane. What will they do against this exactly? Will they try to defend? Every ulti is up. There's a Kotl always on the backside. This Wraith King stands alone in front of everyone, just hitting those barracks. And Starter goes in on the back, tries to get the supports. There's a good Static Storm committed and a Jugger that bounces in between. There's a Finger, but the sustain is too much. That Keeper of the Light is keeping everyone alive, including this Pugna that will not go down, and it's godlike. Everyone goes down except for the Viper that got back in time, and these barracks are more than that. What's the buyback status in here? I suspect they don't have it, and it's GG. It's called from Slaughter. Harlequin calls GG. So Mint takes game one with an impressive show of how you need to 5-man up again and take objectives. And this Wraith King and this Pugna, Jesus. This Pugna especially, I would vote him for MVP because he defeated this Viper mid with an incredible performance, and he ends up 9-1-13 with Greaves and the Necromantic, which was very, very good build for them. So guys, Mint, Mum I Need Tangoes takes game one. We will be back for game two very shortly. I will try to put some kind of overlay here and hopefully get my co-caster for the second game. I hope you enjoyed this, and we'll be back soon. Okay, guys, we should be back for game 2 of Mint versus Kraken Ladies in the female C-League. I finally got my co-caster with me, hopefully. Tim, do you hear me?
10 seconds remaining.
Yes, I do. I am honored to be...
Well, we don't hear you, Tim,
accepted.
So this can be a problem.
Radiant team ban.
Okay. Hello?
Do we have the team speakers on? Well,
yes.
Anyways, until this problem is solved, I will go ahead. Ricky ban for Mint. I need to try to solve this quickly with the other caster. Let's see. What could have been gone wrong? Well, I have no idea, actually. Maybe because there was a party that, Oh well, try to put it on and off again. Meanwhile, there's an Omni Nightman coming from Kraken Ladies. Interesting choice. We'll see very different bans here in game 2. We'll see what this is gonna lead them.
Hello.
Nope, still nothing. Damn it, this is what happens when we don't prepare in advance. There's a silencer ban coming out for Mint now.
It's remaining.
We will be probably not having my co-caster with me, unfortunately, because we can't hear him. At least I can't, so I imagine you guys also can't. Not sure exactly why, though.
Dire team's turn to pick.
Second ban's coming out, there's a silencer ban for Mint and a drow ban for Kraken Ladies. So the silencer, big team fighter hero, that would probably make it hard for them to initiate. And for Kraken Ladies, there's the drow and the... Oh, and there comes the initiator that we were talking about. Mint gets the axe as their first pick.
Remaining.
Tim, can you try to talk again, because I'm not sure if I can hear you now? Or maybe you are gone forever. There's a Shadow Shaman pick coming from Kraken Ladies.
5 seconds remaining.
Another very good push. Can also just be played as a core, and if funky strategy, can go mid, can go just normal support. We will see.
Hello.
Hello, team. Finally, here we go. Both co-casters hear each other.
Phew. Well, I am here. Okay. I have no idea why that happened.
Yeah, just options and things. We are very sorry about this, but I'm completely new for these things. Hopefully everything is alright now. In the first game, we also had a problem with the stream delay because the teams didn't put it up, so I had to do that meanwhile. But everything should be able to go fine now. What do you think of the picks so far, Tim?
It's, I think, curious that Kraken Ladies picked both supports unless they want to do some funky laning, but they have a good push at least, so they have a thing that they're clear plan.
10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, there's this Witch Doctor for sustain, also amazing team fight again, so big team fight
remaining.
Ulti is coming down, but then there's the Phoenix for Mint. So what will this Phoenix be doing?
Probably a support unless they want it offlane, which could be dangerous though against Witch Doctor, since he's a pretty good zoner.
Yeah, so she wouldn't get much levels, you think?
Yeah, they might do Axe Phoenix offlane though.
Oh, that's disgusting. Probably
be a strong duo.
Yeah,
a strong sustained pressure duo.
Yeah, they also don't have ways of dealing with the egg yet, if I'm not mistaken. Do the Mass Serpent Lords attack the egg? I suspect they don't, but I'm not
the
sure.
The Serpent Lords, no, they don't. They would instantly kill it. That would be a pretty nice counter.
Yeah, so this egg so far... Yeah, you're right. So this egg will be left unchecked. And we have a ban, a Void ban for Mint, and a Necrophos ban. Why do you think this is?
I think the Void, the Void pairs well with both supports. It's good in a push lineup to team fight, and looks like their opponents are going for some very specific push death ball.
Yeah, yeah, we saw that in the first game here. Also, Mint just streamrolled everything with this with their Pugna. The Pugna band coming out.
So respect band.
Yep, definitely respect band for that Pugna mid. Also no Necrophos, which is also a very tanky hero. We'll see what comes out next. I'm interested in the Drow band, for instance, because maybe they were expecting some kind of push coming out with the Drow, and they are going for something different this time.
It seems just like the standard first ban, something you don't want to deal with.
Yeah, exactly.
Because it changed the game so much, yeah.
Okay, Ancient Apparition is banned again. It was banned in the game 1, and I suspect it was banned because the team wanted to pick Undying and Wraith King. So they banned it again, but the Kraken Ladies can just pick something they want now. So if they really want, they can block pick some of those heroes instead of letting Mum having those heroes again.
Yeah, it seems Mint really likes the sustained push heroes, because, well, they also got banned out, and the AA ban also suggests that.
Yeah. Okay, there's a Death Prophet coming for Kraken Ladies. What do you think of this now?
This is some nasty teamfight push. It's kind of one-dimensional, but it might work.
And the Puck counter. So we have the Puck Death Prophet mid. Most probably. How's that matchup gonna go?
It's definitely scary sometimes, but I think Puck should do fine against this. It's elusive enough that it shouldn't die.
Yeah, Death Prophet being called OP by several people with her... We like to call it the Sucky Sucky, but the official name is the Spirit Siphon. So, very nasty in lane. So this time, Kraken Ladies also have very strong team fights. They are not gonna just let themselves be steamrolled, although they don't have their core safe laner yet. What would go well here, you think, against this Mint's lineup?
I think the Void ban was good. I'm not sure yet what they might go. Yeah, they need some... Oh, a Windred. That's interesting.
There's a Wind Ginger coming for Kraken Ladies. So now we don't know if this is the safe laner, if this is the off laner even. Who knows? The mids.
It might be a strong female meta hero.
Which would be appropriate, since female C-League, definitely. 5 seconds remaining. Okay, how does this the Wind go though? If she goes mid against the Puck, for instance, and there's Earthshaker. Someone asked for Ada's Earthshaker, and there he comes.
So it's a specific pick, a signature pick.
Apparently it is. I wouldn't know, to be honest, but let's see.
It's good to block the Wind Ranger a bit. The Wind is interesting, though. It doesn't right click the Phoenix, egg that much, because you can't ulti the egg. Mm-hmm. Well, they have three good ranged heroes. They don't attack that much, but they have long range, so it's okay if they manage.
Yeah. I'm curious to see what laning is going to come out of this also, because so far it's pretty open, right?
They might go for a wind offlane or just safe lane. It's a hero that's good with farm still. Or even Death Prophet's safe lane, although I haven't seen that in about 2 years.
We're coming back for the old meta here. What about Mints? Can they do something funky with the heroes they have? Like a surprise axe smith or something like that?
They could, but it's not good against Death Prophet. It's better to put the puck there, because he doesn't get run down by the Spirit Siphon, and Axe does.
So they are missing their safe lane core so far, we would expect, right?
They might. It might also be... I think Kraken Lady still might want to want an offlane or something that can jump in and make some space, because... they need something like that. They don't have the best
I agree.
Early space creation.
Yeah, I meant for Mint. Right now I don't see a safe lane
Mint,
there.
Yeah, the Urza ban comes out. It's a good ban to,
no,
to defend the Death Prophet.
Timbersaw also banned. So, we're seeing a Bristol back for Mint now as their fifth pick. This is very interesting. They can go for another push again if they want a bit.
The four strength hero lineup. They can. It's a bit. The puck and the earthshake are a bit
iffy.
The old ones out. But it's. They have Bristol Phoenix combo for sustain.
Oh, Sven! This we were not
expecting.
That's
a good pick against the Bristol.
Yeah. So basically, that's why they banned the Timbersaw. They saw that that was a weakness that they had, and now this Sven comes out for Kraken Ladies. We are interested in seeing what the lanes are going to look like. So far, we don't really know, actually.
They should be able to defend it.
And here we are, there's a DC already, so we might need to wait for that. Let's see what the team composition is going to be like, most probably. I would really like to see this Bristol back going... well, very aggressive on their ass, basically. Senjin Yasha, all that good stuff. I might have lost my co-caster again. Fortunately, because I don't hear you, Tim. Who could turn away from this battle? Okay, hopefully he comes back.
Sorry, the server's timing me out, but I am back.
Oh, good.
If you hear me.
Yeah, I hear you. Everything's okay now. Game is starting. Let's see how the laning stage is going. Puck mid, as you said, that would be probably happening. And then we have the exact same build for Mylons and Blair on the Winds and on the Death Prophet. So I'm not sure yet what's going on there, but I'm seeing the Wind going for the offlane to place the ward. And she has Winds run skilled, so she's probably going to be offlaning.
Yeah, probably. It's a kind of strange... offlane build, but I don't really know what else she would go. I guess she would go boots first. But...
yeah, or even I personally like to get the Basilius, so I go for the Ring of Protection for extra armor because she has very little armor.
True.
So, but I'm not sure, yeah.
They don't have the strongest zoning support, though, so she might just be soloing against Axe or something like that.
Yeah, you're right. Some action on the runes, no. Everything standard goes for each of them. Okay, let's see how this goes.
They're gonna pressure the Sven.
So mid, we have, like you said, the Death Prophet against the puck. Should be fine for both. And then we have, coming for Mint, an offlaner Earthshaker. With a Phoenix? Interesting, like you said, to pressure the Sven, I'm guessing.
And the Bristol, yeah. The tri-lane, even. they should be able to pressure Sven quite a bit. Because their supports are kind of slow, especially the Shaman is very immobile and unable to defend himself really. Yeah. Phoenix doesn't have dive though, he might be dead.
No, they're going for the Shadow Shaman instead, and the Fairy Fire comes to save him.
Ooh, is he saved?
Oh, Bristol
is... he might be still dead. He has a shackle.
And there's First Blood for... Mint here with this Bristol back that goes very aggressive under tower. He might pay with his life now, though.
He
because,
might.
Yeah.
Yes, he does.
No back yet.
Only one level 1 Bristol.
Curious laning going so far. On the top lane, we will have this Axe going against a Wind Ginger.
The Wind should do fine here because the Axe can't pressure the Herdera so much because of her range.
Yeah, she stays back, she farms. She can't kill him though, probably. I don't know what he has.
Ooh, it gets a double spin though.
Good
that
call.
Hurts because the region is not too high.
Yeah, good call there from Chalk Mint. What's going on this?
Meanwhile, Puck is winning in the mid very clearly.
Oh
for
yeah.
Now at least.
Yeah. Under the network only after Sven. This Death Prophet doesn't.
And the Axe is also crushing the Wind.
Yeah, like you said, probably this build not the best to deal with Axe, because if she gets called, then it's very problematic.
It's, the best, it's still the best 1v1 build, probably, but it's Axe is still a very strong laner, even against the ranged hero.
I think we have another curious streaming problem. Because I can't click the heroes, but it's gonna be fine, hopefully. I see your heroes, right? So you click Sven, for instance, now.
Interesting.
Yeah, but it should be fine. I don't know exactly how this works either.
I guess that means I'm the cameraman.
I hope so.
Expect. Death Road is getting ganked, meanwhile, but the block fails.
And she goes back. So
she's still getting something, but the Puck is definitely getting ahead.
Yeah. Well, we'll see what the game plan is this time. This Wind, like you said, is struggling quite a bit against this Axe that decided to get an early Battle Hunger point, which will make it even harder for her. Meanwhile, bottom lane Sven is being pressured, but he's still the second in network.
Yeah, he still has he has more last hits than Bristol.
Going for the 2 points in cleave.
They are pressuring the supports, but they're still roaming. They tried to gank Puck right now, but she has an observer ward and is chilling in the jungle.
Yeah, now place the
wait,
the ward.
That's actually Death Prophet's observer, but good awareness.
Yeah, there's have the supports on mid now, probably trying to go for her. She will be her or hit or he, because I never know. It's a dragon fairy thingy.
I would go with it.
Definitely it. So it now has his bottle and is doing just fine. And
Axe is still way on top. This might be... I think Mint still definitely has the advantage here, because they're gonna have this strong timing where they get their blink daggers.
Yeah, you're surely right, if this Axe...
She's faking out... she's faking out the battle hunger.
Yeah. Makes this Wind very scared, and then goes to her and just hits her under tower. Make sure to spin a lot. Meanwhile, this Bristle is doing well right now. There's the helm coming for Sven, so the... I hope armored first? Maybe just the helm, though?
I hope so, too, because the helm of Dominator will be a bit too passive to my liking, because they need something to be able to fight in time before they get steamrolled by their double blink deck.
Yeah, I agree, so we'll see. Going on the Witch Doctor now on the bottom lane? This Phoenix coming to work? He should be dead,
he's
but...
He's definitely dead, but there's a Death Prophet. Ooh.
Committed this...
She doesn't have more... Okay, she has one siphon. One extra siphon. The Earthseeker is probably dead. He falls.
So that makes it a 2-for-1 in favor of Kraken here, because of this rotation of the Death Prophet.
It's not the most crisp tri-lane for now, but it's still, it has done something. It has definitely, I think the main point is that they've given their a place to their axe to completely dominate.
Yeah.
Which you don't get if you put him offline.
Yeah, I agree. They tried to push
the
Crystal Tower.
It has done its job.
Yeah, this axe is going towards his blink with great speed here. Also very good levels. The wind was very much crushed. I can't see exactly how much, but yeah, she has her boots now and level 6 and she's coming back.
15 last, it's versus 42. It's pretty bad for the wind. She is definitely struggling.
Meanwhile, Puck also dominates the mid lane.
Ooh. Yeah, they're definitely getting the edge.
See how much...
Ahead in all three lanes right now, and all also the support levels are higher, I believe, at this point. Yeah, it's a bit the same.
So far, so good. Still very...
Looks like a single pool comes out.
Passive game still. This axe, this axe,
no,
this...
Bloodbath yet.
Yeah, this Ven is falling a bit behind because he's being pressured a lot, so the Death Prophet rotates again. I don't know if she has her exorcism.
He did go for Dominator.
He did go for Dominator, so the plan would be to be stacking and farming more, we would expect.
It's also the more defensive laning option. But you can't defend yourself as much by turning. With the armlet toggles.
Death Prophet was visible and she commits a very strange exorcism in the middle of the lane with no heroes there.
Ooh.
Earthshaker TP's out.
They can push off of it though.
Yeah, they will push this tower probably, trying to make you best use of out of this.
Yeah, this tower should probably fall.
They will not
contest.
Or will they? We have a Bristol and
the Phoenix
here.
Is doing much work though. The Ascend can't attack at all. It's another ultimate. It's pretty much wasted.
And there comes the Sunray. Zoning everyone out.
I think they need to back off, definitely. The Bristol is gonna come in now and they don't have other cooldowns to commit anymore.
Trying to save the Witch Doctor.
Though.
And meanwhile, on the
Ooh,
side,
the Puck is dying.
Puck is dying. He did
turn on the Puck.
He did his rift before he was gone.
Yeah,
Death Prophet trying to.
Ooh, it's so
get
close. The Spirit Siphon.
So basically, a 2-for-1 in the end of the day in favor of Kraken again, because the Death Prophet survives and took down the Puck and the Bristol. So.
Yeah. They did a lot of damage. I'm looking at the teamfight recap, but they didn't manage to bring anyone down. They just... The sustain of Death Prophet was just too much.
Yeah, she has a Witch Doctor in her team that will help her a lot, I imagine.
Yeah.
Axe rotates.
They also didn't manage to burst one target.
He has his blink now. Ooh. He does a call on two. Not enough, probably. There's three people there, including the Witch Doctor. And defend themselves.
Yeah,
so.
It's also only a level 1 Berserker's Call, so it's not the longest duration yet.
Oh yeah, he chose to do Battle Hunger instead. Interesting.
that is definitely part of the reason why Wind is struggling so much.
Yeah.
She should be farming on top lane right now, though.
What is she doing?
She's standing in mid with Death Prophet.
Yeah. The tower has been denied, though, so they can't get anything out here.
Yeah.
Vision-wise,
they
both
teams...
They are definitely falling behind. Yeah.
They are about 2,000 gold behind right now. It's not out of the... out of reach, but it's getting... they have to do something.
Sven certainly is trying to, and the Death Prophet commits exorcism again for this team fight, trying to get this
puck. Silence, though.
And the Earthshaker goes down.
He actually managed to get them.
Then the Bristleback, but the two supports.
Door closed, though.
And Axe comes in, takes another. Death Prophet goes down. So this Sven can also be in trouble because
Sven
it's caught.
Explodes.
Yeah, he's caught between all these heroes. And he's
the
dead.
Perfect silence, yeah.
Mint comes out on top after all of this. There was
the
all these ultimates committed.
Are definitely back and forth.
Yeah, still Kraken has to manage their cooldowns. They have big team fights abilities and push that they are not using for towers. This tower is still standing and there's no serpents and no Death Prophet exorcism now.
Sometimes you just have to use it, but it wasn't the best. Also, Puck has a very interesting starting item. She went for the Veil.
More magical damage, though.
No Blink. I guess it's fine because you have Axe doing the initiating for you.
Yeah, this Axe is 3-0-0 right now. It's doing just fine.
Bristol definitely fell also a bit behind, though, because of the deaths.
He's trying to get his Vanguard up, probably. Not succeeding, though. I wish I could click the hero. Jesus. So we have everyone kind of pressuring bot now from Mint, and Kraken trying to defend. This Earthshaker, Immortal, by the way. This is very distracting. His hands keep shining. This is hateful.
It's definitely shiny, though.
Okay, they're...
It's all about the shininess.
They smoke behind their tower. They have only the Witch Doctor visible, maybe baiting.
It's already popped, though.
Oh, it popped, and they dewarded. They are dewarding them.
Instantly, because... they are in trouble, I think. They have Exorcism coming up, though.
Axe is gonna go in, and Axe goes in, two men call under the tower. Snakes committed, Exorcism committed, everything.
He went too early, though.
Yeah, it goes down. There's a Phoenix Egg that they are gonna try to destroy. Bristol is working up on that, but the Phoenix goes down. There's a coil, though, committed for the Sven. Sven goes down, everyone is low, and this Puck. Yeah, this Puck and this Bristol are just going ham on everyone.
The casket, though. The Witch Doctor should be safe, because he's protected by scary snakes.
And he TP's out, so in the end of the day, a 3-4-2. The Sven and the Death Prophet went down, though. So Mint is still going very well on this. They gave a lot of gold with the Axe.
This is definitely in their favor. Also because they don't rely on as big cooldowns as the Death Prophet ultimate and the wards, the Serpent wards.
Yeah, I agree. They have a problem though, they have sort of an early game lineup that can fall off late game, so they need to pressure, and they don't have towers yet.
Yeah, they both have interesting cores that, if they have equal farm, then Radiant is definitely better equipped to win. Because of the Wind and the Sven, but they might not get there.
Yeah, this Wind is certainly struggling. She has only her Basilias now and infused raindrops for the magical damage coming out from Mint.
She is probably going Blink, I would imagine, at this point.
Yeah.
She'll make her fall behind, though, but it's the item that will give her impact at this stage in the game.
Yeah, she could also just go as some kind of farming.
Something on the map also.
I don't know, I like the early Maelstrom, as long as they don't turn it into a Mjolnir later. As we've seen way too much in our pubs recently. Because it helps you have this extra bit of damage that your ulti actually makes a difference, and it helps you farm better. And they pause.
Yes.
There's a disconnect from Kraken now. Some lag, they say. So Kraken is falling behind, but they still managed to get at least the mid tower. Oh, okay, two towers, top and mid. They don't have any vision though, outside of their... Yeah, they don't have any vision on the on Mint's territory at all. Meanwhile, Mint has very aggressive wards placed.
They're a bit scared. They it's hard for Mint to push also, but then
okay.
the bathroom break.
So you were saying?
It's definitely hard for Mint to push because there's so much team fight, but then. Still, they need to push off of it, and if they commit all their, if the wards and the exorcism is committed, they don't have anything else left.
Yeah, I definitely agree. So they will be working around that, we imagine. This axe is going for is blademail next, which is gonna be a big problem against Death Prophet, for instance.
They actually, I think they're actually going two blademails. Because there's Bristol also has picked up a chainmail.
Oh, we can also go for the mechanism, but I doubt that. You are right, probably
it could be,
another
but
blade.
Probably
mail.
Not.
Yeah, probably another blade mail. The Puck has his blink dagger already.
The Puck is very farmed.
And this Puck is doing a very nice game. Top of the network. How many kills to his name? 415 is doing just fine. They are pinging the Death Prophet bottom. They have vision there. They probably want to do something there. We still don't have the Shadow Shaman though. Not sure what happened there.
X has his blade mill on the way also. It's gonna definitely be dangerous.
How are we on levels though at this point?
Mint is a decent chunk ahead.
Yeah, we have level 6 for every support in the game though, so this should be interesting. And we are back.
I think Much is gonna also rest a bit on the Bristol and the Sven, especially the Sven.
Yeah, if he doesn't come
back. He will need to bring the damage, and meanwhile Bristol will need to survive things.
Mint is pushing bottom tower, and they will get it now. With the help of those wards for vision, they know no one is gonna contest. Sven is just trying to farm up. I see he has a... he's preparing his stack also with the help of a creep. Going for is Sanjin Yasha now?
Probably a Sanjin Yasha, yeah, probably. Haven't seen the build in a while, but it's still it's less bursty than the than an armlet's Echo Saber build, for example, but it's
they see
good,
the stack.
Consistent This might be a problem, but Axe can't get it at this point, not with this health pool.
Yeah. They rotate everyone to make sure that they defend the stack.
Ooh.
Probably get some vision up
the
there
wind
also.
Wants it, there's probably gonna be a big contest point.
And Bristol comes
Bristol
up.
Bristol really wants it. Getting the tankiest range creep ever. Go range. Rest in peace. Tanky range creep.
Hey, they have very tanky
they
heroes.
They will need to send the Sven though.
Yeah, if they don't have the Sven, they can't contest this. So their stack is being stolen. We do have the ulties though,
yeah,
probably
this is very
up,
big.
Right? Yeah, Exorcism coming out, trying to defend the stack, trying to farm them themselves.
Really early though. And
a shackle latch
have...
on Axe. Phoenix uses her sun ray to very great effect, but there's still the Exorcism going down. Witch Doctor falling
the
low.
The Puck is also doing really work with the Veil.
Yeah, Witch Doctor goes down, wind goes down, magical damage keeps flowing in. There's a there's a phoenix egg that's gonna survive.
It's popped. Defroth is draining so much HP though, they really can't deal with her right now.
And she gets a double kill. Axe goes down for her, she will lose her life for that though, which makes it a 4-4-2 here, so Mint comes up on top again. But Sven survived this. They managed to get a bit of a stack, if I'm not mistaken. That's his Sunch now.
Yeah, they should have, because the Sven is... the Sven is also gonna steal a double stack.
Oh yeah, there he is. Payback time, he says.
Sanjiash is almost up here. He definitely got the most out of that fight on the team. Oh, and at the Death of it.
The puck is still on top of the network. Is... What does he have now? Still with this? Oh, fair bit of money. I'm curious to see what he goes next.
Power threads and. Maybe a Dagon actually to burst Daffrofus. That might be a good choice, or to burst the wind. Who is going Maelstrom actually?
Yeah, wind is going Maelstrom. Meanwhile, the Daffrofus picked off her own wolves now, so she can deal better with the silence coming out from the puck.
She is a bit squishy though, but she's still surviving a lot, so it might be enough.
Yeah, Puck trying to go on her, he does a fair bit of damage and he commits coil. And the enforcements are coming out as Axe with his blade mail, and they are gonna get that shadow. And now they're gonna go for the Witch Doctor, it's a double kill. Death Prophet has no other solution but to come back. She still has Exorcism that she can use if she wants to. There's Sven also now, but they are not backing off.
Probably can't use it though.
Yeah, she preemptively.
I don't think they can take this tower though. It might be a bit early because they're respawning the supports.
Yeah, they should be back
to
the fight now. Bristol is just being on the face of them, and then Axe calls in.
Ooh,
he goes in, he gets Sven. That blade mail doing some very good work, and Exorcism finally committed.
Sven's very tanky though.
There's also an egg coming out, so it's a bit of a confusion, but the supports start to go down, the egg implodes. Bristol tries to survive this, but he can't. It's not enough. Maybe they overextended a bit, and it ends up being a 1-3.
They definitely did. I think the Deathrot would have died if it wasn't for the Yules, because she was hurting herself a lot, but then she made herself invulnerable with the Yules active.
Yeah, so it's a good choice coming out from this Death Prophet mid. I am sorry, by the way, if I'm not saying the players' names. It's purely because I don't have them. For some reason, I can't see them on their hero, so I'm gonna always say the heroes' names here. They're going for the mid tower, but meanwhile, I missed this.
Ooh.
The Puck got a kill bottom on that wind.
Puck has definitely much solo damage with that fail. Personally, I really want to see the Dagon come out.
That would be, yeah. I know how you like Dagon, so yeah. That would be interesting. They take the mid tower though.
I know how you don't.
Yeah, but in this game, I agree, it would probably be a very good option against this lineup. Well, good news for Kraken is they are getting those towers. They are still getting something. That Sven is coming out finally on top, especially after this team fight.
Yeah, it's the Puck is having still a really good performance though, considering that to keep up with a Sven is a very good performance.
Yeah, definitely. The Death Prophet going for the point booster next, I wonder, is this a Nocturne Core, you think? Is this the Bloodstone?
It might be a very early Nocturne Core.
Yeah.
I think it might be.
What do you think of that? Will that help her in this teamfights?
She might need a BKB though. It's she's doing a lot of work with Spirit Siphons, so the sustain is strong. But the Puck, if she goes for Dagon, she might just die if they focus her a bit.
Yeah, and that would be a good idea probably, because she's being one of the main reasons they are winning these team fights.
Ooh, getting shackled though. Oh, was that a bait? I think that was definitely a bait.
That was a bait, and the wing is gone for this axe. But the Sven comes in, he commits his ulti, and he gets
the Phoenix.
They are going on the axe now, but that Fisher just saved the day. So
yeah, they have very good disengage also with this.
Exorcism comes out though.
Ooh.
Axe still. Oh god.
Ooh,
this is gonna be. This is gonna be.
That's completely saved Puck though.
Yep. This Sven though, the damage is unbelievable. They are trying
the
to kite him
though.
Around.
He might turn on Sven.
Crystal is gonna
Crystal's
fall though.
In the front.
He also has the Witch Doctor Maledict on him, so we will probably.
He's barely living.
And he fell. The Sven also backed off with his life intact, so this is gonna go even more in the way of Kraken, because this Sven, it just no one stops him. He goes in and he hits everyone on the face.
Yeah, he's very tanky with this build. It's a very in-your-face, consistent teamfight hacking build.
And he still has the damage thanks to his ultimate, so
yeah.
Very good stuff coming out of him.
The blink is also picked up.
Oh, interesting.
That calls though, barely saved the Puck. The Puck barely survived the cleave damage.
Yeah, this axe. He is falling a bit behind now because he's dying on the steam fights. He has a plate mail added, probably going for that Shiva's, I would say. Or even, Shiva's, because the AC might go for the bristle. Is a good idea.
They might be a Lotus Orb. It's pretty useful.
That would be.
There's many single target disabled, so it might be worth it to go for that.
Int still has a very fair good vision. Oh yeah, they need to defend this Bristle. This Bristle can't die like this. Is going for the Buckler now?
Crimson Guard, yes. I'm not sure if I like that.
Well,
I don't think it blocks Exorcism Spirit damage, but I'm not sure about
no,
that.
No, it doesn't. It
should. Inconsistent.
Yeah, it should though, because
it might,
it's physical damage.
Sure.
So if it does, then it's a good idea because they are falling for that. This entire team. If he manages to use that, it's gonna be super good for them. They are gonna push this top tower. They're taking the vision off. Meanwhile, Mint is busy not defending because they are going for this Roche for Sven probably.
I think it's worth it to put on the Sven, or the Wind picked it up. That is curious.
She's also going for the Shadow Amulet
going...
here.
Yeah.
So.
The Shadowblade Wind, maybe?
Interesting. Exorcism committed.
The ulti is popped.
After they back off from the tower, they go on the axe.
They're going back in though. Are they bursting or. No, the ulti.
X is gone.
I don't think they can reverse the Death Prophet. Or can they? Ooh, the Puck has the damage.
The egg is gone also. But then this Puck.
Ooh,
oh, this Puck.
For good measure.
Witch Doctor doing some work, but the Puck
These
is still.
These fights were so close. They're just going back and forth.
Right now the Puck is trying to survive this Sven with Wind. Might
Ooh,
be able to do this.
Didn't get the blink off.
Oh no, didn't
think
get the.
She lives.
She has a
yes,
blink now.
She should live.
No, there's another.
So Lucifer, oh god. But there's another ball. There's,
another
orb.
A veil.
And
she's
alive?
Out.
She should be alive. The jukes are real.
This Puck.
They just give up. They don't want.
So what would be this
they
team fight recap this time? Who comes out on top of this?
It was very bloody. The tower did fall. I don't think they care, but they did pop the Aegis also on Wind. I don't think there were any buybacks in that fight, no. There wasn't.
No. Sven is going probably for the BKB now.
Yeah, this game is very close. It's yeah, it should be a BKB. I don't imagine it's a late Saber or anything. The dominated siege creep.
If this pug keeps doing Sven. This amazing team fights, he might get this for them because the Bristol and Axe, they are just dying on these team fights. They are not being able to control this Sven. They are not dealing as much damage as they would like. The egg is being popped. And they are smoked, and there's gonna be a team fight bottom.
They're around the blade mill, be decently. Ooh, the puck might be dead though.
Sven goes on the puck.
Sven even. The great silence from the Death Prophet. But she's dead, probably. Yes.
And the Sven also is gonna almost die.
Ooh, the movement speed.
That speed is Sven just runs away. So in the end, it's a Death Prophet for a puck.
The Sven got the kill though, and Herbshaker also dies now.
So it didn't quite work out for Lynn.
Bristol killed Death Prophet.
They were trying to get a smoke gank clean up, but they didn't manage to get that Sven, especially. They are pushing on mid now.
Is falling behind now, though. But there is a full soul booster on the courier, though. She has some more items.
And they are going in again. The Sven goes and hacks.
Ooh, the BKB comes out. But the axe is doing work. But it is a very tough game against the Witch Doctor.
Also,
the Maledict is so dangerous to all the heroes.
Yeah, Maledict is working really well for them. And the Sven goes trying to chase down this Phoenix on the mid lane. After just killing everyone, cleaving everyone to death. He just doesn't care, he has his BKB now.
Very bloodthirsty. Ooh, there is also that Bristol. Unless the puck is
Death Prophet
magical,
managed to pick off the Bristol. The puck is gonna trying to survive. There's exorcism committed for this. This exorcism is coming out very hasty on the finger.
Premature.
They will not have this.
Yeah, very itchy trigger finger.
Yeah, they will not have this now for pushing on the bottom lane. That will hurt them a bit. Fortunately, the Sven doesn't rely as much on the cooldowns as the Death Prophet for sure, so.
It is actually a bloodstone for the Death Prophet. She purchased the recipe and
the
soaring component.
Interesting, so she wants to make herself more tanky and.
Ooh! A full hex on this puck. This is a very farmed puck.
So we were thinking we were gonna see a Bristol versus Sven action here, but suddenly there's actually a Sven versus Puck action, which is a very interesting matchup. And the Sven is a pig right now, he's being called, maybe he was too greedy, he is left alone. And he will be out.
Ooh.
They almost had him with
the Culling Blade.
Yeah, Culling Blade, they should have been more patient.
I don't think they had enough damage. I don't think they could in any way kill him, because it's only, 400, maybe barely, if it was perfectly timed.
The Shiva is completed now on the axe.
Ah, so it is a Shiva's. I would maybe like the Lotus Orb, because the coconuts are doing very much work, and also it completely counters shackles. Uh-huh. You can't shackle him at all, the target at all.
Yeah, that's true. The axe just asserting dominance on that top. Going against this wind. This wind is shackling nothing now, so she has to run away. Meanwhile, they keep pushing that mid tower. There's no exorcism right now for the Death Prophet, I think.
No, it's just 20 seconds though, but the tower should go down before that.
They are trying though, and the shackle comes out on the Bristol on the back though. The Sven tries to be going on the puck, but the puck avoids it, and it's a bloodbath again.
Bursted, but the axe is doing work.
The egg comes out.
There's no
axe
ulti, though.
Axe used it. So the support ends, the Death Prophet go down, this Witch Doctor will also go down, but Sven meanwhile also took them on the back, and this axe is probably gonna fall. Oh no, there's the pig coming out, that axe, saving the day there. And Puck is gone.
I just don't know where to look in these fights, it's so crazy action-packed and back and forth.
Yeah, this Sven tried to go on the back lines, he got some kills, is now going for the Phoenix is
there's no
gonna
mana for a stun though.
He's trying
but
to get her.
No dive.
Almost. There's
oh,
dive now.
So close. Fly
oh,
away.
Oh,
bird.
Oh.
No.
Mistakes and the
no.
snipe. There he goes down for the Wind
secured.
Ranger. This Wind Ranger
so
has a very, very special build. She's going for the Maelstrom into Shadowblade. And now, I guess she's going for the axe finally.
Staff. It might be the axe, yeah.
Hopefully not a 4 stuff, because she has enough mobility as it is.
It's a mobility build.
Well, in the end, the Sven comes out on top still, getting more and more gold to his name, and the Puck is following him very closely. That Scythe of Vines.
Kraken is getting a bit brought the net worth back also over the last 10 minutes. But it's still so close. This really could go any way.
Is it because of the steam
Although
fights
the
you think?
Goes... Yeah, the Sven is staying alive right now. The BKB is also helping with that.
Good choice of items.
Later
coming
it goes
out.
Though the more Mint is gonna struggle probably because I don't think the Bristol also especially with this last late game build can't carry that late. Versus a Sven.
So Mint is looking at the clock right now, and they are like, it's time to do something, guys.
They are. They have been attempting, though. They have had the initiative for the whole game from the start with the aggressive fire lane, but they haven't been able to win decisively.
Axe. Trying to see
Axis.
If he can do something. No,
yeah,
he's gonna TP out.
Something.
TP out instead of staying
the
there.
The Wind needs to run.
The good idea.
She has a Shadow Blade. I don't know if there's vision on anyone.
Top action.
The
Puck is going on the Death Prophet though. Death Prophet to use herself, but there's also Earthshaker and there's this axe. She will go down for the axe. Dunk. Shock Mint is dominating. She's 12-6 right now, but the Sven. Sven just picked off this Bristol back on the bottom lane with the help of the Witch Doctor. We can't keep track of
it
all of this.
It can't be clean. It's just... There are no clean exchanges. It's just... There's no clean wipes or clean pickoffs. It's always... there's always some exchange. It's so close.
Yeah, to make it even more clear that is what's happening. We are looking at 29-29. That's right now.
This Wind has definitely caught up. She's almost as farmed as the Axe. Getting even close to the Puck.
Oh, yes.
More farmed than Death Prophet and the Bristol.
That Shadowblade might just have been the thing that saves her on this teamfight. Also giving her that extra edge of attack speed when she didn't have her ulti. And now her ulti was going to be always up. So, yeah. This Wind is going to be very much aggressive now. I would say.
Very dangerous, yeah.
And they're going on the top lane though, trying to push a bit. Axe always on the front. But they TP back the support also. They don't want to give up this barracks here. Probably Sven.
No, they need to give up. They need to go back with the Sven. He has a TP. He probably needs to use it.
Someone canceled the TP though. I'm not sure if it was the Sven. No, it wasn't the Sven. The Sven is here now. Someone was TPing
and the Witch Doctor cancels probably.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They are trying to bait, but Mint is not falling for this, and they are getting back now. Witch Doctor has now a 4 staff and a glimmer, so he's also going to be very useful in this fight. He's not dying as much as he was before. He's sitting at 4-5. Compared to the 10 deaths of the Bristleback, for instance.
The Shaman is still a bit behind. He would like more levels. It's
yeah, this
it's
Shaman
very level dependent,
is...
You know, and there's only a level 2 either shock.
Yeah, this shaman is not being the greedy support that it should be this game, because he can't do much. He puts the serpents and he usually just dies after.
Yeah, the puck and the bristle and the axe is the reigning dominance over the supports in this fight.
Bottom tower is gonna go for Mint now. Death Prophet's peeking a bit to see if she goes or not, but probably not. There comes a good shackle on the axe. No follow-up though. They leave vision there, and that's all, and they will back. They don't want to
It's all for the quest. It's all for the shackle quest.
She's trying to get that set finally. Well, let's be honest, it's really hard to get the red one.
It is definitely sometimes a struggle to get shackles, two-man shackles.
Mint here going for the Rosh
HP,
though.
But he's... Yeah. The Bristol is a bit low on HP pool.
Yeah, yeah, the build that he chose with that Crimson Guard, and that's basically he's going all in the armor. Right now he's sitting an absurd armor, yeah. But he doesn't have HP to go with that.
30 armor.
Yeah, exactly. He went all for in for the armor, so he's trying to evade that.
Ooh,
Sven.
The Sven,
the Sven comes in.
Completely bonkers. No BKB though.
BKB activated. Ooh, now. BKB, it tries to survive this. Their snakes is caught up between the. And he goes down. The Rosh helps a bit.
Ooh, that's painful. But the Death Prophet.
Aegis is
the
there.
Still on the ground.
And the Death Prophet gets it.
And the. They also got the kill.
She's gonna drain this Earthshaker now.
There have been a few mistakes. Mistakes have been made.
This wind also, so much damage. Ooh. Now coming out of her. And they will push bottom. They will try to do something with this exorcism, but the exorcism is gone, so yeah. That is gonna be a trouble.
Yeah, they can't really push. This is interesting. The Sven didn't go pop BKB, but that made sure that everything was used on the Sven, so then the Mint didn't have anything left to go on the Deathlock, but that just walked in and wiped them.
Yeah, definitely. So maybe that BKB coming out late for the Sven actually helped them in the team fight, but Sven still goes down.
Maybe in a weird way it did, because they might get Rex.
Puck is gonna try to defend here. Puck goes in and
yeah,
comes out again.
Not does Puck have anything to say about it. They defend.
Tower goes down. They see the wind, and the wind goes away with her Shadow Blade. They need to get some vision on this Mint lineup
they
if they want to
dust
deal.
On
anyone, probably, I think.
They don't have dust on anyone, no.
Yeah, they need to start dealing with this with this wind, because they forget about her, but now she has the tools to take heroes like Bristol back down very quickly.
Yeah, she's third on the net worth. Coming from that awfully hard top lane, it's definitely a good comeback.
Well, they also heard us at least, guys. There's the dust coming out from the Phoenix.
Caster curse, just praise the wind, and then she instantly dies.
There she goes. Where did she
never
die?
Players.
I never
just
saw her.
Die in the mid lane.
Damn it.
Peacefully farming, but then Puck. Puck's not having any of that.
Well, you praise her, but we also praise this Puck. This Puck has a Crystallis, guys! This Puck is going crazy!
Ooh.
I expect Bloodthorn coming out.
Probably, but it's interesting that she goes for Crystallis first.
Well, she knows those right clicks. Damn, those right clicks, man.
Damn. Almost.
She's hitting for how much right now, Tim?
It's... The crits are about 300 on creeps, I think. Yeah, 337 on creeps, which is decent.
Look at those right clicks go on the
Sven
peak that Death Prophet is. Death Prophet is almost dead. They will go down on her, but then there's...
There goes Sven, though.
Oh, she still falls. And there goes the Aegis.
The creeps are ridiculous.
Is Sven working
on
the egg?
The egg is gonna pop.
The egg popped, and the Sven is in trouble right now, but he still has his BKB, but he's going down to those right clicks. See, the right clicks from this Puck are amazing. Death Prophet cleans a bit up. Oh no, he's controlled, he's shackled, he's dead. And it's almost... Oh, it's a team wipe.
Really just
Sven dies again, but they come back on top.
I guess this is the closest to a clean wipe we had.
But it's not super clean
because the Sven went down. Yeah.
What is this?
The Death Prophet did buy back.
Oh, the Death Prophet died back. Oh, what does she have now?
Oh no, she didn't buy back. It was just fast Bloodstone respawn.
Oh, also, and she had Aegis. Yeah, the Aegis went down for sure.
Oh yeah, it's Aegis. It's not the Bloodstone. Yeah. Yeah, it keeps being this story of whoever seems to commit too much loses the teamfight eventually.
And
the wind is not here for the push though, so they can't take this tower probably.
Well, they are still trying.
The Shaker.
The Shaker is probably not gonna try anything funky here, since he's alone. But yeah, the wave is gone,
the
and they will
back. Crazy echo slams.
They will back off.
Meanwhile, Shaman still has a salve. Come on, Shaman, use that salve. Low HP.
It's not like he has problems of slots now, right now, so I guess it's okay.
No,
oh, I suddenly see the name of some players. Oh, wait, it's gone again. What? Okay. I saw the name of Shadow for a second, and it was Venus something, and now it's gone again.
Virus.
Oh, okay. Interesting vision coming out, blocking these camps for
There's also Kraken. A full Daedalus on the Sven right now. He might have had it the other fight, because he did so much damage that probably he had that.
Yeah, so he goes in like crazy. It takes so long to die, he kills everyone. Giving his life for the team.
The Bristol has the EC also now.
Oh, that will help them survive a bit more this Sven, hopefully. Game going passive again.
Yeah, a bit help for the Death Prophet also. But
the wind is gonna.
They need to kill this Death Prophet, but she has the BKB now. Plus more gold. She is definitely.
Exchange charges
doing
also.
Work at this point in the game. The Daedalus Puck comes out.
Oh!
That is interesting.
Okay, so he really wants to right-click those people down. And they smoke!
So, instead of something like the Dagon, just... Instead of doing it with magic damage, just do damage with right-clicks, I guess.
They are smoked up and they are ready to
go.
They also used scan to try to check for someone. Everyone is bottom, they are moving bottom to get them.
They are hiding.
Yeah, Kraken knows something is up.
They saw them smoke. They saw them smoke.
Smoke breaks in the wind. Dust is used. Ooh. This wind might be in trouble. And she goes down. Punk. Exorcism committed. Big kibbies go
can
up.
They stop. Bristol is just dying though.
Bristol is just dying to this
Sven.
There's an egg though, and the egg is probably gonna pop.
The Death Prophet is also doing work. They don't care though about the egg.
No, they don't care because
the
Daedalus
right clicks are not enough.
This Sven is taking everything. Ooh. It's a 4-for-1 here.
Yeah, I don't think the Daedalus Puck skills as well as the Daedalus Sven.
I don't know why you say that.
The clock is with. The clock is definitely with Kraken. They managed to weather the storm a bit.
Yeah, that is very interesting. There's a buyback on the puck trying to defend this bottom barracks. And they will back off. They are satisfied with that.
Ooh. The turrets for the puck though.
Yeah, exactly. The puck is gonna be very far behind now with this very strange build of augmenting his magical damage, but then also trying to get some right click damage. It's not working. They also have a Sven who gives armor to everyone on the team, so it's not necessarily the best.
Yeah. I think actually I still would really like to Dagon more, even than Bloodthorn, because they have so much ways of stopping the Orchid or the Soulburn.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree.
Except the wind, but I don't think she cares as much.
The wind is going for her MKB now. Excellent addition for what she has already. no evasion.
Very offensive build though.
Offensive build, she's okay with that, I guess. If she gets caught up, she will die
she
anyway.
She died the last fight though, but...
Yeah, she was caught up, she was the first one.
If the axe catches her... Yeah, nothing defends you against the axe.
If it doesn't though... And that's the good stuff. I'm curious to see what the Sven goes next. Exactly here.
He has a recipe, a satanic recipe.
Oh, a satanic recipe.
Yeah, it's probably gonna be satanic. Oh, also there's Boots of Travel already picked up. So probably satanic moon shard, and that should be it. Could replace the Sanji Yasha. But then yeah, it's still you lose the movement speed. And you might not want that.
No, it's being very good for them as they always goes behind in fights and always manages to get either the Bristol or some important support on Mint. Oh, they were trying to go bottom, but reinforcements are coming. There's gonna be a team fight here probably. No, Mint decides they don't want any of this and they back off.
Yeah.
They are dewarded.
They don't want any part of this.
There's a Sven and the Death Prophet sitting at a very big HP pool. And there's something we haven't talked about yet, which is this axe, Tim.
This axe, I was just gonna say, that's gonna be dangerous. Because I don't think he gets cancelled much. I think the ultis have been doing, and the hero is just completely just doing a lot of work.
Yeah, I agree.
The net worth of Witch Doctor is even close to the Bristol at this point.
Yeah, this Bristol falling off really, really much with this build that was trying to get survivability but ended up not being enough.
Yeah, it's just the Sven is a good pick to deal with Bristol because he does such an overwhelming amount of damage that he doesn't really care, and also the quills, the hero doesn't really care about the quills because of all the armor that he stacks up.
Totally agree. Also, he goes late, and then Bristol doesn't have much to say on that. They have definitely way better late game in Kraken than in Mint, and Mint is not being able to finish this game, and we're sitting at 50 minutes now of game.
Yeah. Ooh, they took a free Rax actually at this point, and the Sven is going deeper. Oh, the Phoenix is.
How did they do this?
Alive.
I missed this. I was busy seeing them going in the mid lane, and suddenly there's this.
They didn't do this.
Oh, the Death Prophet
the
though. This Death Prophet exploded. Now it's the time for the axe, and there's the tank.
Is...
Double kill for the axe here. Barracks are gone
though. This axe is definitely MVP contention.
Yeah, definitely. He's been doing an amazing game, amazing calls the entire game, saving this team fight that otherwise would be completely one-sided because they still got the Bristol and they still got the barracks. So we're talking one barracks down for Mint right now. If they push this lane.
There's some good individual performances, I think, on the axe and the puck especially, but it's... they just as a team, they haven't been able to push. And that's the big difference maker here.
Yeah. As also, like you said, I'm not absolutely sure about this Daedalus picked up for the puck, because he doesn't have also the opportunity to just right-click, because he needs to be constantly fending off all these menaces, right? So he pops out on all these places and teamfights and is not really being just sitting and right-clicking anything.
BKB puck? Easy right-clicks?
Yeah, that would be an idea, but then he had to deal with this Death Prophet and her damage. So, also, there's the Wind that now has her MKB. So they have all the tools they need in Kraken. They can just let it go later and later. They have one barracks down for them now. They can be looking to Roche next.
The Sven is almost completely maxed out, though.
They are drawing on the map, team. I see this line. They are saying we go bottom and we take everything. What can
Sven
do?
I think Sven needs to pull out some big fights though. It's they need to be able to kite this Sven in some way.
Yeah, this Sven. Does he have a moon shard, by the way? I can't click him, so I can't.
No. He's still going for the Satanic, it's not up yet.
So you will have a Satanic, you will have a Moon Shard, and he still can sell that Senjin Yasha and go for later MKB. He can go for another Diadalus if he really wants to, I guess. What else can he go here?
Yeah, he might just keep the Senjin Yasha then.
Yeah, it's tanky, he's fine with that. He can even get a heart if he really wants to. Look at his life right now.
Yeah.
Gonna be really hard to shoe up this. Okay, they were trying the Roche, but this puck just says na 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 na. And now he comes back off again. Oh no, he's trying to do him himself.
This puck wants the Roche.
No. He's like, okay, this is not enough, guys.
This puck has a plate mail, which I'm not sure what it's gonna be because they have a Shivas already. It might be also a Shivas.
Might be another Lotus though, like you were saying for the. You were saying for the axe, yeah. But it might come out for the puck.
I'm not sure she's gonna go that though.
It would be interesting because she is being very controlled, actually. Yeah. Last team fight, she was shackled, she was hexed, or.
Yeah, I would like a BKB on the puck. On the puck. Because just. Yeah.
The amount of magical stuff.
It's kind of an unconventional item build, but it's. There's so much disable at this point. The silence, she doesn't have any defensive items.
Yeah, that's true. There's no way wolves coming out, for instance.
Yeah. And you can't Yule out of, or Lotus out of a hex. Not yourself, at least.
We'll see what is gonna come out here for her. Also, this wind is now the third on network. What you said still applies. She was an offlaner that was losing so hard for the axe, and now she's just... Oh, hi. Here I am.
Casually holding almost 6,000 gold. Might be going for a crit next.
Boots of Travel?
This has the Octarine also.
There's the Octarine.
Travels. Yeah.
Travels. Travels coming out, so she basically can just TP on the top lane, for instance, if there's a team fight going on, and she will take basically whatever she wants with her ultimate. They need to be careful with this.
Yes.
Oh, there's the Shivas indeed, like you said. So they are trying to get that armor. Bit curious though. I wonder if it's miscommunication because now the two Shivas though.
Hmm. Yeah, I think they just might want to have it. They maybe didn't consider the Lotus choice. I think it's best to get on the axe probably.
Oh, there's something going on the Roche.
They want it, but they're scared. They should be also. This Octarine Death Prophet is scary.
Yep, she has everything. She looks at them and she says no. Don't even think about it.
She doesn't have armor though, but it's...
Yeah, but it's not matter. So she doesn't need to have armor because the Bristle doesn't go on her. The Axe doesn't kill her quick enough.
But the Daedalus Puck.
Daedalus Puck is not killing her either. She doesn't need armor. This is a Death Prophet. She doesn't need anything. She's not even... She's below the axe on the network, and she's still like, oh yeah, I can just go here in front of my team.
I think she still goes to the Shivas after this.
Exorcism committed. There's the serpents, and the snakes. This tower is melting. The Sven uses ulti, so he's ready to jump in at any point. Mint needs to do something, but they don't know exactly what. And the Sven comes in, he uses BKB, and he goes AM. A good call though coming out, that call might just almost save them, but no!
The Satanic saving the Sven.
And he goes finally down, but the damage is done. There's no barracks, one of those. This Witch Doctor will fall. There's a buyback for the Sven out of all
buyback on the Sven, but is he gonna die again? To this axe.
He's trying to go ham on them, but he realizes he can't do this. His life is going. And this is a buyback for the Sven. Ooh, oh my god, he's out for 100 seconds. And this, it's a team wipe. Mint just managed to hold. Yeah, they hold their racks and they do.
No melee racks, at least.
No melee racks, but still, they punish Kraken really hard here.
I think Kraken would be fine with it if they didn't have a dieback. Or, let's see. Or more buybacks than just the axe. Yeah, the axe definitely did. This axe is a team player.
Yeah, he's been doing these calls.
Back. Just every fight. Completely selfless calls, just... Don't attack my friends, or I will... make you attack me.
And is there now pushing a bit on the mid lane, because he knows there's nothing they can do, and they can just... get back after this. Death Prophet is just sitting there trying to defend it. Everyone will be up soonish. This Sven though, Jesus. That buyback, that was not the choice to be made there.
No, now the puck is the same net worth as Sven again.
it was just
manages to keep up.
Yep, this puck was like, oh, that's exactly what I wanted from you. Nice buyback, bro.
Yeah.
Now I have my boots of travel.
The puck actually almost has the same last hits as just 11 last hits less than the Sven.
That's Diadolus, Tim. That Diadolus. I never doubted. You doubted, but I never did.
I never. I definitely agreed. No, I had my doubts, but definitely still slightly debatable. But
yeah, but it's making work for them, and they are trying to push mid to get back a bit on that barracks that they lost.
There's the Mjolnir wins.
Oh, Jesus. She gets this shackle. There's exorcism coming out. Big team fight going on. All the ultimates used.
The ding ding.
This Bristol is gonna go down.
The Bristol is dead.
Sven is like, I'm back and I have my BKB. I'm going for this puck. Puck is very difficult to kill though. It just goes away. Ooh. Just blinks away. So they committed all these things to kill two heroes and then try to march mid. But this Earthshaker. This Earthshaker is gonna fall. That makes it for 3-4-1. Are there buybacks though?
Ooh, there is.
There's a buyback for the Phoenix. There's no buyback for the Earthshaker.
No Earthshaker buyback. And Bristol bought back also.
It's not gonna be enough probably though. They are going for this barracks.
Ooh, there is backdoor protection though for this hack. These attacks were wasted. They can go now, but now they can defend.
They back off because they realize, no, with these buybacks, we can't do this. They will just TP out.
The Sven barely TP'd out, the Hex was too late. They could have killed the Sven again, that would have been really big.
Now, what happened after all of this? Mint team wipes them, keeps their barracks, they try to push, they overextend again, they have to... buyback, and we're back to square zero, I guess.
Yes. Let's see, what can they do? I think Puck should sell the veil and go for eggs, actually, because... I just see the Sven walking out of the ulti with his BKB, and with eggs you can't do that.
Interesting, we'll see if he goes for that. It's a good choice, he has a lot of money on him right now, so he can just do something with it. They are going again, though, Mint. Maybe they know
yeah,
they can't
they
just...
this base.
They need to do something because they are missing a barracks, they are going on to a late game against a Sven. But it's really hard to push into this though. They have winds to clear up, they have a lot of stuff to clean up these waves.
Wind is also ratting. They have multiple travels and right now they have zero tier 3s, so they can't rely on the tier 3s clearing out creep waves, so they constantly have to go back, so... Mint is definitely still in a...
tight spot,
precarious
I would say.
Position. This wind.
Yeah,
what is she doing?
You know my opinion about those Mjolnirs, but the thing is, with it, she can just push the entire wave, and if she uses the ulti on something, she still has all this attack speed to go immediately on another building after.
I think she wants this Rax. I think she's gonna rat the bulldog place.
She is there. She is there, sitting, chilling on this... she has her Shadow Blade now back again. There's no vision here for Mint. She can just walk here and they will never know that, actually. But she doesn't know that. There's no way she knows.
She can't kill the Rax, though. There is... I think she wants the Sven and Defro to kill this creep wave in mid. But the Bristol is... probably dead.
They are coming back. Where's the action? Oh, this
they
Bristol.
Are in trouble, though.
Oh, the Bristol just
1600 crits.
This Bristol wants a BKB, but he's not gonna get it. He doesn't have buyback.
I think this might be over at this point. The Sven just commits his BKB.
No, these barracks are going down. And
I think this might be boiling down to a bit of an anticlimactic ending though.
Unfortunately. Oh, but there's the egg. Oh!
The
they are trying!
BKB and Satanic. But it's not enough, is it?
Oh, there's even Witch Doctor and it's controlled!
The
this puck is controlled!
Puck has a buyback.
He has to
the
buy
magas
back,
are
but.
Up.
And there's the Megas. Megas
yeah,
come
it's,
up
I think
for Kraken.
They can't defend properly.
Bristol is still down, no buyback. They can just keep going. This wind, look at her damage!
Ooh, the puck.
The Death Prophet also, they do no dent on her! Oh, but there's the call from Axe, trying
ooh,
to get
the
something
axe.
Done!
The Axe.
Ah, the Sven goes down! They defend
Sven
against
has
the Sven.
Okay, it's getting buyback.
This Phoenix is battling
the
this Death Prophet. Ah, double kill for Axe! They are defending,
ooh.
The game is not ending here, they
this
say.
Death Prophet is
you
dead.
Make it a triple kill for Chalkmint. Just this Axe going ham on them. He's trying
there
everything he can.
Both cores, though.
Yeah, they can't probably do anything
so I don't
against
think
this.
They can. Yeah.
He has a heart now.
This Witch Doctor has Guardian Greaves also.
Oh, okay, that will not help
why
them.
Not?
Yeah, that is bad news for Mint. Mint
yeah.
needs to do something. They have Megas against them
yeah.
now. They kind of need to either push all in or they will surely lose
ooh.
The game.
This Bristol actually really fell off, but I haven't seen this yet. She has 17 deaths on the Bristol.
Jesus,
the
this
first.
Bristol is just feeding the Sven, probably.
Yeah, it's really hard to just survive against this. They're going down mid, the
desperate
play,
attempt.
But the wind is ratting.
The wind is there, the wind says, oh yeah, really, do you want to try this against me? I have a Mjolnir, I have my ulti up, I can just take this tower if I want. And there goes the tower, she's going for it.
They get the racks though, but the Deathrot is defending with ulti. They also have buyback on her.
Tower is
yeah,
gone.
They're TPing back. They
and this oh Jesus, they have no vision for the wind. The wind is gone. She just took the tower and went back.
Ooh.
So
well,
they took the barracks, but
for a lot of tower damage. I don't think it's worth for two tier 4s. It's they're all down and all the small buildings are down.
Yeah, the throne is
no,
completely yeah, throne is exposed. They can just walk there and throw bodies at this throne.
Yeah.
And they possibly
there's no exorcism, but they are fine probably.
Yeah, this axe needs to do a 5-man call or the mint is probably going to go down here.
Yeah.
And guys, we all wanted this Divine Rapier coming out. Oh, yes.
Ooh.
Oh, that
this
damage. Okay, it just it literally
in
goes
style.
Into base with this new purchase. It says, oh yeah, I'm gonna click everything, the game is
this
over.
This is gonna be some 2000
he goes in,
it
hams.
2200 crits, that seems good.
They all need to run away, but this throne
yeah,
is going
throne
down
is
to for the serpents. It doesn't even need to do anything. They are not even clicking it. There's just this amount of incredible amount of serpents taking him down. But the axe is still doing what he can. Try to salvage this. Axe, what do you do? But it's not enough. I'm sorry
it's
for
not
this.
Enough.
Kraken takes game two with this super farmed Sven at 66 minutes, and Mint goes down. They fought until the last minute, but it wasn't enough.
They fought so hard, and it was close, but yeah, the late game lineup pulling through.
Yeah, this Axe, he really was the MVP for Mint, but it was still not enough because the Sven farmed and yeah, look at this.
The wind also, it's an excellent comeback.
Yeah, excellent comeback from her, also just doing the weird game with the Shadow Blades Mjolnir build that actually worked out pretty well for her. Even the supports got some decent farm on this 1 hour game with the Greaves and
yeah,
Refresher.
Yeah, the Witch Doctor especially that didn't much work.
Yeah. Okay, Okay, guys, this was the last game for this series. There will be more series coming out soon, if I'm not mistaken, in around like 1 hour or something. I will not be casting them with team. I'm not sure who will, but someone probably will. So stay up for that, and we are gonna go now. So bye, team. Bye, everyone.
Bye.